Hi guys, welcome back to another video. In this video, I'll show you how to create a business email address for free. So basically, you will have to use any hosting provider. And for this tutorial, I'll be using the Hostinger. If you're using Bluehost, it has the same features for Bluehost. If you're using Namecheap or maybe most of the hosting provider has free email options where you can create a free business email. At the same time, I'll show you how to connect that business email with your Gmail accounts so that you can reply, you can receive email directly to your Gmail. So without further any delay, let's jump into my computer. So you can see here, I logged in into my Hostinger account, and I personally use Hostinger for all of my personal websites and client websites. I really enjoy their services and I have been using Hostinger more than 3 years now, but it's doing really great. If you want to use Hostinger, I will attach my affiliate link into the video descriptions where you can purchase your hosting, and I'll receive a little commission from it as well, and it will help me to support this channel as well. So here, after logging into your hosting account, you will see there is an option called emails. So just click on emails here, and you'll be able to see your connected domain inside your emails area, where you can simply click on manage. So I'm going to add another email in my Riyad Mahmood portfolio website. So if I click on manage, there is already an email address that has been created already, which is contact@riyadmahmood.com. So instead creating allies, I'm gonna create another email for my businesses as well. Let's click email accounts. As you can see, there is an email already, contact@riyadmahmood.com. Now if I click create new email account, it's completely free, and type here, let's say I'm gonna create this email for my editor, and type here editor or support team. Let's create support team, because sometimes I receive a lot of support requests from some clients, so it's good to have individual email for supporting. And let's make, as you can see, there's an options, make this email account an admin. If you do not want, then just skip this part and create a password here. I'm gonna select automatically generated password from here. And you have to remember this password. So if I click on this eye icon, you can see the password is displaying here. And what I'm going to do, I'm gonna copy this password and go to any notes or any note takers. I'm using the default notes from Mac, and it will help me to add quick notes. So you have to keep this password and email so that you can recover and you can use this connect to your Gmail account. Now click on new notes. I'm going to place it here. Okay, type here business email notes and add recover email address here. Click create new account. That's it. It shows a bad request. I don't know why, but let's change the name to something else. Let's make it instead support. Maybe I have already allies for support, and that's why it's displaying here. So let's change it to my editor name, called Shahila, and click create new account here. And as you can see, the account has been created. Now if I click over here to access webmail, it will take me to the hostinger.titan.email, and click over here, it will log in into your Hostinger Titan emails. Now click next and paste the password that we created here, and also copy the email address at the same time and paste it here, because it will require again. Click login, and here is the recovery email. You have to confirm this one, or you can just, I'll do it later, but it's a good practice to confirm the recovery email at the same time in case if you see any issues, so that you can recover quickly. Now here you can see, this is the default email view or the dashboard or the features basically. Let's type here Shahila and click I'll do it later, and I'll do it later. So this is the default email where you can send and you can receive email itself through the Hostinger Titan emails. But if you want, you can manage this email sending and receiving options from your Gmail accounts. And personally, I'm not gonna use this one, and I do not use this Titan features from here. I always use my business email through the Gmail accounts that I'm using right now. So I'm going to show you how to configure this one instead using this Titan options here. So you have to search on Google Titan email outgoing and incoming. So just click over here, and you can see there is some configuration for IMAP and POP. So these are the configuration for incoming emails and outgoing for outgoing emails, like sending and incoming. So these features and these options is required. And if you do not find this, I will share with you the links into the video description so you can land directly from here. Now I'm going to navigate to my Gmail account. So basically the Gmail accounts that I'm going to use here. Let's keep it side here, and here is the Gmail accounts. And when you logged in into your Gmail account, you have to simply click on settings and click see all settings, and after that click accounts and import. And here I'm gonna check first, so check mail from other accounts, add a mail account. And it will open a pop-up here like this. And now I need the email address that we created and paste here. Click next. And you can see here imports email from my other account through by the POP3 features. Click next. And the username should be the email address again. And the password that is we have added here. Password. And now the POP server, we need to change the POP server here. By clicking here, here you can see we are gonna receive the email address, and that's why for receiving it's incoming server. So here we are not going to use the IMAP method, we are gonna use the POP method, and that's why we have to use the incoming server poptitan.email. Let's copy. And where is our pop-ups here? Paste here, which is the POP server, pop.titan.email, and you can see, let's make it side by side, and you can see here there's a port 995, and this is encrypted method, so make sure you're following the same 995, sorry, this one, and leave a copy of retrieve message on the server. I do not want to leave because it will increase the server memory, it will take the server memory from the email itself. I just wanted to use it on my Gmail, that's it. Okay, so here the second one is always use secure connection when receive email or retrieve email address or email. And then label incoming message. The label means when received an email, it will add this shahila@riyadmahmood.com as a label. And you can also archive this, but there is no need to archive this from the inbox. And that's the two things that you have to check from here. And just click add account, click never, and then it will mention you your mail account has been added. And if you want, you'll be able to send email as or shahila@riyadmahmood.com. So if you want to send email from your Gmail accounts through this email, then you can also do it. Now it's time to send outgoing settings. Click on next and type the name here. And now click next step. And here is the SMTP server settings that we need to copy from here, which is the smtp.titan.email. Paste here. And the port is 465. And the username, Shailer email address, username is the email address and the password. Let's use the password, this one. Paste here. And secure connection using SSL recommended. Click add account. So as you can see, it mentions that confirm verification and add your email address. So congratulations, we successfully located your other server and verified your credentials. And it will send you an email into your Gmail account that needs to be verified from your side. So that's very important. If you do not verify that email, then you're not gonna use these features. Let's wait and verify our email. So it might take some time to receive the verification email. Let's reload here a couple of times. And sometimes you have to navigate to the settings. Okay, so before navigating to the settings, it's appearing here. So as you can see, it's labeled as shailer@riyadmahmood.com and then the Gmail confirmation as well. So if you just click over here and now click on this link here and then click confirm. Confirmation success. So we have completed our email systems, like we completed our business email here easily without spending any amounts or without spending any money on it. So if you're using any other hosting, the process is same. They should have some features like the IMAP or POP settings. You have to find out or connect to the hosting support and receive those information and then connect with your Gmail. That's it. That's very simple. And I hope you guys like this video. And if you want to receive or get more videos like this one, then please hit the subscribe button and comment below how you enjoy this video. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a good day. Bye.